Hi, Joe Cerrone. Welcome to this week's Zoom video meeting for CAD 230. If you look at the outline of topics or the upcoming events, Module 4 and Module 5 are due today at 11:59, and we pretty much keep up that rate. So 6 and 8 are due next week, and you might say, well, where is 7? 7 is a midterm, and we're not going to have time to do a midterm because we've only got 4 more classes, including this one left. So we'll go 6 and 8, and then 9 and 10. And then 12 is the final exam. And what you really want to do is start looking toward the end, where I believe Module 9 goes through and does assemblies. And so as we're progressing through the course and the content for it, we've started off with these different part models. And then we pick up on all these different commands like shell, extrude, taper, and rib features. And then we progress into patterning, mirroring, and array features. And so we have linear, circular, more circular patterns, and then curve-driven patterns. And again, these are bonus. You don't have to do them. I'm finding a lot of people are doing them. Module 6 gets into part configurations, which basically just allows you to see different ways that the part would be represented. And so we kind of have this engine block right here. And then if we go to our part configurations, we can then show it as a cutaway view. And so these are good for 3D printing and for also being able to show different configurations without having to create separate models of the parts. And then after we get through part configurations, we'll go into threads. I really like the threading tools. They added, I call it the thread wizard. It works like the hole wizard, where it will automatically cut predetermined thread sizes with either a tap or a die. And so you can then 3D print these parts out of plastic with threads. If you do put threads on, and most people who make big assemblies don't do that because it starts to eat up a lot of CPU time, you can then create these working models. And so that's 8. And then 9 is where we start getting into assemblies. And so you really want to get to the point where you get up to assemblies, because that's where SolidWorks starts to come together, where you're able to take these part files that we did, I think, in 4 or 5, and then be able to put what they call mates on them. And it's kind of like virtual Lego, where you can put these parts together and then you can apply these different mate constraints, which will take away the different degrees of freedom so that you don't have things like parts that will kind of walk through themselves. They'll actually collide with each other and bounce off each other. And so that's really the thing about SolidWorks that makes it very useful, is the ability to go through and create these assembly models. And so you want to kind of be working up until 9, and then 10, we do more of these mechanical mates. 10 is really not a very difficult assignment. If you have time, do 11, because 11 will show you how to create detailed drawings of the parts. And so you create a model and then you drag them into the different views and align them orthographically. And it's a much more automated way of detailing your drawings. 12 is the final exam, and that'll be coming up at the end of July. And so we'll make that available the last week. We may make it available a little bit earlier if anybody wants to take that earlier. And then I also added a practice test. At least I thought I did. Maybe if I refresh this, it'll show up, because there it is. It wasn't showing up because I didn't refresh it. And so there is a practice exam. And what I do is I give students my own final exam, but I give them the choice of if they want to take the CSWA exam. And the CSWA exam is great. I have a voucher for you if you want to take the exam, but it's a 3-hour exam. And you could also take it in the intermediate course. And so if you're starting to think about what you're going to do with your courses, my recommendation would be see how you do with the course. And then if you're prepared to take the CSWA exam, I'll give you the voucher. And what you do is you take it with this virtual tester, and you can take the test from home. And if you pass the test, you'll get a SolidWorks certificate. And the test looks like it's in chapter 21 of the book. And so the textbook goes through and explains it. Actually, it's 22, I guess, how to study for that exam. And my exam is very similar to that. So with that said, that's kind of our goal as we're into July and we've got 3 weeks left. You're going to want to keep an eye on where the end point of the course is. And so we're going to be covering two more modules next week and then two more the following week. And then we will be ready for the final exam. So we have two and then our final exam. With that, I'm going to end this Zoom video meeting and open things up for questions.